say a few words about this piece. John Cage's Sonatas and Interludes is really a kind of journey around the world. At the time that he wrote it, he was looking for a sort of universal music that would speak to people, that would incorporate sounds from different cultures. This is 1946, when it wasn't so easy to just YouTube it and find out what gamelan sounded like. And so he did a lot of percussion music and brought a lot of instruments in from around the world. And this piece is sort of his way of capturing a lot of these sounds with the prepared piano. So there are about 75 screws and bolts and pieces of rubber inside of the piano. I welcome you to come up after and try it out a little bit if you'd like. It's a pretty amazing technology that he invented in the late 30s. To transform the piano. So about half of the notes are not prepared, and so you hear a very interesting combination of prepared sounds with unprepared sounds. And ideally, you have this kind of, your imagination floats and takes you all different places. You might hear Chinese gongs, or Indian tablas, or African drums, or, you know, it's sort of all into this piece. So it's quite a journey. I'm pleased that you're here to take that journey with me. My journey with this piece began about 4 years ago. I was in Thailand at a music festival, and I met an American pianist, Bennett Lerner. And Bennett is in his mid to late 80s now, I would say. And Bennett worked closely with John Cage on this piece and many of his other prepared piano pieces in New York in the 70s, 60s, 70s, 80s. And Bennett and I got, you know, we went out to the Italian restaurant after the concert, as you do in Thailand. And we had some pizza and wine and got talking. And by the end of the festival, he said, you know, I'm not really playing anymore. Would you like this set of preparations? So he shipped me a box full of all of these beautiful old screws and bolts that are rusty and well-worn and really resonate beautifully. And so I had to learn the piece, of course. So I've been playing it for a couple of years now. Every time you prepare the piano, it's different, so you have to be kind of in the moment as a performer, which is really an interesting experience. And it's always a little bit different. So that's really fun to play. Every piano is different, right? John Cage wrote the piece on a 5-foot Steinway, small Steinway, maybe grand in his living room, and this is a 9-foot piano. So every time it's really quite different. So the piece also reflects Cage's interest in Indian philosophy. He was studying the permanent emotions. There are 8 of them, which I won't remember them all, but it's the ones you would think of. There's anger and sadness and humor and happiness. But the 9th permanent, those are emotions that we all share. Everybody around the world, doesn't matter where you are, we share these emotions. The 9th emotion is tranquility. And so the idea is that all of these emotions sort of work together and lead us towards tranquility. And so that's really the shape of the piece. It's a piece that explores many sounds in 20 short movements and leads you towards tranquility. As a way of kind of keeping this prepared piano going into the future, I've asked a bunch of composers to write pieces for me, new interludes, using the exact same set of preparations. So I'll be playing 4 of those brand new pieces written last year. This set continues to grow, and so I have now about 10 of these new interludes. So it's new appreciation of this instrument and new sounds that can be developed by composers. So that's a really exciting project for me, especially as a composer, to have these new pieces come into it. So the pieces will be sort of relatively listed, you know, so you can kind of follow along. There's 16 sonatas and four interludes, sonatas in groups of four, and then there'll be four of those new interludes. So it sounds like a lot, it sounds like a long project, but it really, if you can get into that journey, it will lead you towards tranquility. It's about 70 minutes long with the new pieces. So I hope you enjoy the journey with me, and I'll see you at the other side.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's, you can even try a little bit, see what it feels like. It's a little bit like running on concrete, but it's great. So thank you for listening. I hope you had a tranquil afternoon, and thanks.